In this video, I'm going to show you how you can turn a photo of yourself into something cool. Alright, let's go on and import our image. Click on import, photo library. And yeah, first of all, I'm going to select this image and click on add. So, I know you guys know what we want to do. We want to swap the head off. So, what we want to do first? So, I would like for us to make a duplicate so we can have a backup copy. Just in case we mess things up, you know. Click right here. And duplicate. Done. Once you are done. So, the first thing first, let us get rid of this head. You know, you click right here, click on clone stamp tool, make the brush bigger. Once you are done, so this is the source, you click and then just brush around to remove the head. I'm gonna click on source again. Yeah, if we have time, you can knit it up, but I'm not going to focus on that right now. I think this is good enough. So now let us import our image or whatever image you want to import. So click right here, click on this photo library as always, photo layer, then photo library. So you can use your image for this or image of your friend or any image you want to use. Okay, click on done. So like we did before, let's make a duplicate to make a backup. So duplicate this, let's turn this off, let's take it down to the bottom. We don't know if we are going to need it, so make the up on back and active. We want to erase the head area. So first thing first, you click right on toolbar, click on marquee selection tool and scroll over to lasso selection tool. Let's just draw a lasso around the head area and click right here and extract. Yeah, so let's deselect that, click on this and click deselect. So we want to erase the corners, the background from, we just need only the face and the head. So we click on this again, scroll to the top to paint tool, and scroll all the way to the right to select your eraser tool. So let's click on brush, make the flow 100% size, make it a bit smaller. Done. Let us brush around the corners. You don't need to rush this step, but for me, I'm just going to do this really, really quickly. You can take your time to do it very neatly. So I'm going to make the brush size a bit harder. Okay, I'm going to need a smaller brush for this point, make it soft. So like I said, you can take your time to refine this even more. So let's bring the brush back up. Take the hardness as well. So I'm just going to do this very, really quick because you don't want to watch me all day doing this. So take a look at this point. It's kind of hard for my fingers to go right through it. So what you want to do at this point is to click right here, click on show pointer. So as you can see, we have a little bit of extension. So now you can just click on anywhere on the screen and you can just, so let's make the brush a bit smaller. You can just brush around. Oops. Let's forget that. So let's turn the pointer back off and make the brush size bigger again. And yeah, let's go. Yeah, we've got to the point where we want, so now I'm going to make the brush even bigger and just brush around this part. We don't have to be that careful anymore. Take away the corners. Like so. So now that we have got rid of the entire body, so first thing I want to do is to make a duplicate of the head just for backup sake. So you click here, duplicate it. In case we make a mistake, we can always come back. So turn it off and take it to the bottom. So let's reduce the opacity a bit so we can see behind it. Let's take it a bit upward. And now let us resize it. So click right here and transform. So I'll make it smaller. Going to rotate it a bit. Can work on the placement. I think this is okay. So once you are done, you click OK. After that, we bring the opacity back up. Alright, not bad, not bad. So let's just make a smooth transition at the neck, like so. Oops. So as you can see, this sharp edge right here, that's not, let's see what we can do if we can transform it. Let's rotate it maybe. And now it looks better. So let's click done. Now what's left is to do the color balance and the contrast. So first thing, let's make a copy. So you click right here, click here and duplicate it. So just keep on doing this. You don't know where you're going to make a mistake. So you click this again. The first thing I want to do is to reduce the saturation. As you can see, the head is a bit more saturated. So we click on adjustment, saturation. So let's reduce the saturation. And I think it's good at this point. And I think it's okay at this point. So I'm going to click on done. Now let's go to the contrast. As you can see, the skin, the body is a bit more contrasty. So let's go and replicate that. So you click right here. And I love using curve, so I'm going to use curve. So we want to make it contrasty, right? So take the right side, which is the highlight a bit at the top, and take the downside. And take the left side, which is the shadow, down. Like so. So now let's work on the color balance. As you can see, the head is a bit more reddish, and the body has a little bit of green to it. So first of all, let's go to the red. I'm going to reduce the red. Like so. Why not? So let's go to the green. I think reducing the red added more green to it. So let's see if we can't reduce the green. Nope. That's fine, right? I think let's see what the blue channel will do. Let's go to the blue. So we don't want to add blue to it, we want to reduce blue. So we're going to take the blue bit down. Okay, let's click on OK. So this is the before and after. So I think maybe I should take the saturation a bit more to the bottom. And yeah, I think this good as done. So we're going to click on done. And that's how you do the swiping stuff. So let's take a look at the before and after. So this is the before, and there is the after. Does look cool, isn't it? So if you have time, you can mesh this together. So let's mesh it together and apply an overall effect to it. So it comes to saturation, maybe you reduce the saturation, come over here to temperature, you can increase the temperature. This is applying a global effect to everything. And then you can come to curves. Let's undo this at first. Let's go to the first one. You can add a little bit of contrast to everything. Let's take this part up and this one to the bottom. And you can come to this red channel. You can increase reds at the highlight, reduce it at the shadows. Let's come to the green. Increase the green at a light. You can reduce it at the shadows. And finally to the blues. You can reduce the blues at a light and decrease it at the shadow. So before, after, whatever the one, whatever you like best. And that's how you do it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.